This is Jack from No Code MBA, and today we're going to look at 5 no-code business ideas that you can build in 48 hours. Now, it might take you a little bit longer than 48 hours, but the idea is that these are quick to build. And the business side of things might say to take some time, and obviously there are different things to think about, but the basic premise of getting something out there can be done quickly. And we're going to go through 5 of the ideas from an article that we wrote, 11 profitable business ideas you can build without code today. So all of these are going to be no code. They're going to use tools such as Bubble or Webflow or something like that. And we have some other business ideas for you that go to more depth of some of the ones we're going to talk about today and some other ones. And I'll leave the playlist in the description for you. But let's get started with idea number 1. First one is going to be a job board. And the idea here is that you can build a job board for a specific industry, and examples include design jobs, remote jobs, and healthcare jobs. And we made a longer video on this. Again, I'll leave a link to that in the description. And we actually have a tutorial on how to build this in Webflow. So how you can use Webflow and the CMS and dynamic pages in order to create this job board post. And even if you don't want to build the actual job board, but maybe something similar, then this tutorial is going to be really good for you. And this is part of the courses that we offer. But going back to the idea is that you, once you build up the job board, you can monetize it. Firstly, you need to add jobs manually to your job board. Then you can charge companies for highlighted job postings and email newsletter postings too. So the idea here is that some companies are going to want to hire quickly. They want to get the best candidate. So they're going to say, we want to pay you in order to have our job posting featured on your website or in the email newsletter that you send out. And you can start with a low price to get your fair posting and increase this over time. Now you can also monetize in different ways where people looking for jobs can pay to get access to certain jobs or pay to get their CV seen first, those types of things. Now, in terms of getting users, we have a few different ideas here. Content marketing for SEO to drive search traffic. So over time, you can build the content marketing up so that people looking for jobs will land on your website and then see that it's a job listing site. You can post your job board on related online communities on Reddit, Facebook, Twitter, etc. You can collect emails of visitors and send out weekly newsletters. So this is all about sending newsletters about new jobs to your to people who have signed up to receive them. And then you can also post the jobs on social media too. Say, hey, is anyone looking for this type of job? It's on our website. Come apply on our website. Now, I'll leave a link to this article too and some of these links here of people who've been doing this profitably so you can learn about this. But this is the first idea, which is a job board website which you can build using Webflow. Now, the next one that we really like as well is a paid newsletter. And this is to write a newsletter for a specific industry. Could be about anything that you know about. Obviously, you're going to have to be able to offer value for this. But the idea is that you're going to monetize it by starting out as a free newsletter to your first subscribers. And over time, you can add a premium level subscription with additional content for a monthly or annual price. So we can think about Substack here. Now, another way to monetize this as well is to use something like Swapstack, where you can find brands who want to advertise within emails. So it's not just about the users paying for the emails, it's about advertising within that email too. So in terms of how to build it, you can use something like Substack, or you can build a custom blog yourself. And again, we have a tutorial on how to do this in Webflow, how to build a custom blog in Webflow. I'll leave a link to this course in the description too. But you can build it yourself at a paywall with MemberStack, or if you use WordPress and you have different plugins as well that you can use. But a lot of people will think, okay, I want to use either Webflow or Substack. And Substack is a tool that you can use to create this tool without actually having to build it yourself. Now, the idea in terms of how to get and retain users is to share your newsletter on Twitter, share it on LinkedIn. You can post on a regular schedule so people know what to expect. And obviously as well, what we can do is give some free content away on our blog, and then people can subscribe to get access to the premium content or to more content down the line. Now, number 3, which is actually number 4 on this list, is a dating app for a specific niche. So this is getting into something else now where we can build it using Glide. And just like the other ones, we have a tutorial on how to do this. Build a matching dating app like Tinder in Glide. And this is a fun tutorial to take because it's going to show you different ways to build an app using Glide. So even if you're not wanting to build a dating app, this course is going to help you because you're going to learn a lot along the way of actually building something like this. So then you can adapt it and think about different ideas that you can build using Glide. But just going back to this, the idea here is that we create a dating app for a specific niche. And I'll leave a link to this 10 ridiculously specific dating apps, which is a really fun article to read. But just like dating apps in general, the way that you monetize is to charge for premium features, including unlimited matches, for example, being able to swipe right all day if you wanted to do that. But the idea in terms of getting users is to post in related online communities and Facebook ads as well to gain users of your specific niche. And then as you build up the dating app over time, it's going to get popular and then people will talk about it and recommend it. And if you make it fun in terms of the niche, then you'll also get highlighted on articles such as this. Now, the next one is to help businesses using Zapier. Now, Zapier is a tool that allows you to connect apps and automate processes. And what you can do, the idea here is to use Zapier to automate tasks of small businesses. And there's a great example of someone doing this, Andrew Davidson of Luhu. And we actually did a case study on this, which is a really good video because it's going to show you how he got started, how he scaled, and what his plans are for the future. But the idea here is that you're going to create tasks for businesses. So you're going to see what kind of problems businesses have and then say, hey, I can solve them using automation. And you don't even need to talk about the tool that you're going to use, but you can say, I can automate tasks for your business and save you this amount of money in the process, or I can help you scale by automating different types of tasks. And the way to retain users is to send code emails to offer your services to local businesses. So you have some kind of landing page, you say, hey, this is what I do. You get in touch with businesses and you say, come and find me and I can help you with these problems you have. You can use LinkedIn to get clients through your existing network. Initially, that's a great way to get started with anything, is to say, this is what I'm doing, talk to your network, talk to your group and say, come and check it out. And then as you build up your portfolio, you can get referrals from existing clients. Now you can also do things like content marketing here. You can also advertise and use social media in general. But these are three great ways to get and retain users for a business like this. In terms of monetizing, you just charge for each project you complete. Or you can have a subscription model if you want to build something out and to scale it. And the last one we want to share in this video is to build websites for local businesses. And it's quite simple, this. It's build simple websites for local businesses like restaurants, salons, or movers. We made a full video on this if you want to check it out where we go into more detail. But the idea is that businesses struggle with the technical side of things and you can come in and solve that problem by building websites for them. And we can do this in either Card or Webflow or another website builder, where you're building out the websites using these tools and you're also creating your landing page and your services using these tools as well. Now, in terms of how to monetize, there are a couple of ways. You can charge a monthly fee to build and host the websites with updates. So you can say, I'm going to run these websites for you. I'll make changes, I'll host them, etc. I'll make sure everything's working well. I'll update it as we go to make sure everything works correctly in the future. Or you can choose charge a larger one-time fee with no monthly fee. So I'm going to build your website and then I'm done. Or you can build your website with a larger fee and say, you can retain me at this price per month and I'll do a certain amount of updates for you. But a big website redesign is going to be charged extra. Now, in terms of getting business here, again, we can send cold emails to local businesses. We can also really just network, not only on LinkedIn, but just network in your local area. So if you know people in your local area, get the word out there that you build websites and you can help people with it. You get referrals from existing clients, post in related Facebook groups. Again, if it's a local group, you can just talk about be active in that group and say, I offer website design services. And you can also go on websites such as Upwork to find your first clients. So those are the five business ideas that we can build using no-code tools, and we can get this done fairly quickly. Now, if you want to learn more about these types of ideas, then check out this article on our website, but also check out the playlist that we have on different business ideas, and also the playlist that we have on no-code success stories, so you can get inspired from people who have done similar things like this. So if you found this useful, then please like and share. Be sure to get our no-code guide. It's free to download. Click the link in the description and enter your details to get that. And also check out the courses that we have, because a lot of what we talked about in this video, we have courses on exactly how to build out something like that. For example, a dating app. We talk about how to build a blog in Webflow, how to use Zapier, and other things too. So thanks so much for watching. I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now.